My name is Henk Blom. I'm working at Saba for 23 years and I'm the manager technical service. We are a company that produces adhesives and sealants. These here is an application for solvent-based adhesives. We also have water-based adhesives and also hot melts.
We did a lot of testing in the early days. That's the reason why we came up with the stainless steel pumps with Teflon diaphragms and balls, and actually haven't had an issue since. So that means that actually the pump withstands all the raw materials and all the chemicals we are using over here without any issues. This can be water-based raw material, resins, solvents, all kinds of raw materials that you use to build a glue. From very modest raw materials up to really aggressive raw materials. The part of the production we are looking at right now is the part where we are producing the low viscosity products. Those products are really sensitive to shear forces. So the reason why we use the welder pumps over here is the fact that those pumps create less shear forces than your average pump out there on the market. The pumps we are using over here are the same type of stainless steel we use all over our production. One of the reasons we are using them is we did find out that with other types of pumps, we had to kind of clean them every week, which took 1.5 to 2 hours, man hours. And with the welding pumps, we are currently cleaning them like every 3 months. So that is a huge savings of about 1.5 to 2 man hours per week. Second reason why we selected those pumps is the product we are putting out to the market needs to be clean, fresh. The more shear forces you already put on in the production, the less the shelf life will be afterwards. So by selecting the right pump, we kind of extend the shelf life of our product we send out into the market.
We were looking for a pump that we can use everywhere and that also has those special features that we need. So this pump, the most of the pumps we are using are stainless steel with Teflon. This is one of our first applications we have. We had this Weldon T2 pumps in operations, I think, since the early 90s. This pump is probably more than 20 years old and still going strong.
Well, I think that Saba probably needed a pump which it's really performed well,
yeah,
in pumping these difficult sticky materials. And as it turned out, it has been a great solution.
Yeah.
And before they had issues with leakage of the pumps.
With these welding pumps, we don't have that problem.
We have a long history of testing all kinds of different pumps, mostly double diaphragm pumps because they are mostly used in our industry. But about 20 years ago, we switched to welding pumps, and actually we have stayed with them ever since. After 20 years we found out that they are reliable, it's a good company, we have a great backup, and actually the money we have to put in to maintain them and keep them up and running is very low. So we are very, very happy with those pumps.
ESG, where innovation flows.